With this update, we are excited to announce the addition of Onshape AI Advisor to Onshape. The Onshape AI Advisor is an AI-powered expert in Onshape, built using Amazon's Bedrock technology and initially released in the Onshape Learning Center. You can think of the Onshape AI Advisor as your personal Onshape expert available 24/7 to answer any Onshape questions you have, and it's available to everyone. So why is this so important? From day one, all of Onshape's learning materials, from the help documentation to the Learning Center to tech tips, what's new, webinars, and more, have all been freely available to everyone. This has been an important part of Onshape's core philosophy and is different than many other CAD systems. This means that over the last 10 years, we have created tens of thousands of individual pieces of material to help users learn Onshape. That library of material is the source of truth for the Onshape AI Advisor, giving you a natural language means of interacting with over a decade of learning material. So, what kind of questions can the Onshape AI Advisor answer? Let's take a look at a few examples. To access the Onshape AI Advisor, simply click the Onshape AI Advisor icon in the document panel on the left-hand side of your document. Let's say that I am a new user who is looking for advice on creating my first sketch pattern. Here, the Onshape AI Advisor gives me a step-by-step breakdown of the process that is much more accurate than I would get with any other assistant. It also comes with citations back to the source that was used to generate the response. This is particularly useful when you want to dive deeper into the topic. But that's a simple example. Let's go further. Let's say that I want to know, how do I stop my tool from colliding with my part or fixture in Onshape's new Cam Studio? Here, the Onshape AI Advisor recommends defining work holding, running simulations, and defining collision groups to avoid collisions in a Cam Studio. Now let's go even further. Write a conditional operator statement that says if the trailer width is less than 28, the value should be 4. If not, the value should be 6. Here you can see the Onshape AI Advisor gives a perfect response that can be copied and pasted right into a dialog. It's important to stress, Onshape AI Advisor cannot see your data and is only using Onshape's library of learning materials as its source of information. Onshape AI Advisor is available to all users directly in Onshape and in the Onshape Learning Center. For professional and enterprise company admins, you will find a new company setting under preferences to either enable or disable Onshape AI Advisor for your company. By default, Onshape AI Advisor is disabled for Onshape Enterprise customers.
Creating highly parameterized designs just got more powerful in Onshape. Variable Studios allow you to manage all of your critical design values in one location. Now, you can configure those values. Like Part Studios and Assemblies, you can choose from a combination of three input types. In this case, a list is selected. The electric motor in this document will have three variants, one that prioritizes torque, a balanced output, and one focused on speed. Each variable can be selectively added to the configuration input, where each value can then be customized for the specific requirements of that configuration. When inserting the Variable Studio into a Part Studio or Assembly, you will now have the choice of which configuration to use. This configuration can be freely changed at any time, and any references to these variables will be realized immediately. To really take advantage of configured Variable Studios, you can select which configuration to reference using the configuration inputs of the Part Studios and Assemblies referencing the Variable Studio. This is a simple connection to make in this design, as the three sizes are all we're going to configure it for this example. But you could make these configured parameters as complex as you desire. The Variable Studio configuration selection will be updated for all the other Part Studios in this document. This enables the variables to drive many different parts and assemblies across the entire design. Finally, the top-level assembly will also be updated to reference the different configurations of the parts that have been created, as well as the Variable Studio, bringing everything together. With configurable Variable Studios, we're now able to create specifications for multiple variations of a design within a single document, utilizing the power of configurations in Onshape.
In this release, Onshape Simulation has received a large update. New solver and element technology now allows you to more reliably and accurately simulate thin-walled and high aspect ratio parts, such as sheet metal components and frame elements. The solver will automatically adapt to these components without requiring any additional definition from you, the designer. Just set up your fixtures and loads as you normally would, and hit Show Results when ready to solve. While these changes will most drastically affect thin-walled parts, we expect it to yield faster convergence and decrease solve times overall for simulations across the board.
In this update, I'll insert dialogs in Onshape across assemblies, drawings, and other apps like Render Studio now include an option to insert the active configuration of a model. When working with highly configurable parts or assemblies, switching between multiple configuration variables can make it time-consuming to locate the correct setup for downstream use. With this enhancement, Onshape automatically recognizes the configuration currently active in your workspace and makes it selectable directly from the insert dialog. For example, after adjusting parameters in a configurable assembly, you can now generate a drawing or a render using that same active configuration, without the need to go back to the original reference to insert default parameters.
Onshape Professional and Enterprise now support searching for custom properties applied to folders and enterprise projects. For example, if your organization has set up a property like folder type, you can search directly on that value to find exactly the folders you need. This means engineering teams can organize projects by properties such as product line, work type, or program phase, and instantly filter results without browsing through every folder.
While in the document view and you expand the folders list, you can adjust the location of the divider that separates the folders and the documents. Onshape now remembers and persists the location of the divider as you navigate through your folder structure, documents, and persists across sessions. Break views now support shaded display and Onshape drawings. To change the shaded display of a drawing view, right-click on the view, select Hide Show, then select Show Shaded View. When creating an inspection document or a copy of a document with inspection information, you may want to start fresh. Onshape now provides the ability to remove all inspection elements from a drawing with a single right mouse click option. This significantly reduces the amount of time when you need to remove these elements from a drawing.
Onshape Enterprise now supports external connections, enabling secure collaboration between separate enterprises such as OEMs and suppliers, all within the Onshape ecosystem. Here's how it works. To establish a connection, one enterprise requests access using the other organization's enterprise ID found on their Enterprise Details page. Once the request is submitted, an admin from the other enterprise receives an email for approval. No data is ever shared until the connection is approved, a user is added, and that data is explicitly shared through the standard share dialog. Documents shared through a connection display a blue badge, and a banner appears on share and comment screens to indicate collaboration across enterprises. Connections can be managed from enterprise settings, where administrators can view, approve, or remove linked enterprises at any time. Onshape Enterprise now gives administrators finer control over data security with new export permissions. By default, all enterprise users can export data, but now administrators can remove that global permission and grant export rights only to specific users or teams. This update helps organizations protect sensitive information while still allowing authorized users to collaborate and share data as needed. Render Studio now includes new navigation and layout options to make refining your scenes faster and more intuitive. The Libraries panel can now be positioned on the right side of the screen instead of the bottom, preserving valuable vertical workspace and giving a clearer view of your render. This right side layout is also closer to where you're working, improving visibility and reducing the need to scroll or toggle between panels. The tab order has also been streamlined for a better workflow. At the top is the Libraries tab, where you'll spend most of your time browsing and searching for material textures and environments. Below that is Appearances, followed by Environment, and then the Scene tab, aligning the way most users build, light, and finalize their renders. These improvements make Render Studio easy to navigate, more efficient to use, and better optimized for wide format displays. New in Render Studio is projector manipulators for improved texture control. Each projection type, planar, cubic, cylindrical, and spherical, now displays an on-screen manipulator. showing how each texture is applied. Textures can be translated, rotated, and scaled visually, making it easier to align and adjust materials without guesswork. Both uniform and non-uniform scaling are supported, ensuring textures look accurate and consistent across surfaces. This enhancement gives designers more precise visual control over material appearance in Render Studio. Onshape now supports workspace references for non-geometric data, such as HDRI backgrounds, textures, and other rendering assets. You no longer need to create new versions just to update these files. They stay linked and always current within your workspace. Parts and assemblies still use version or release references, ensuring your 3D data remains controlled while your visual assets stay flexible. This keeps your rendering assets live and up to date, while parts and assemblies remain version controlled. PCB Studio now supports suppressing individual items from imported ECAD data from systems like Altium, so you can hide what you don't want in the Onshape assembly without removing it from the ECAD source. This keeps your mechanical view clean while ensuring ECAD won't interpret the change as a deletion when you round-trip data. Here's how it works. To change visibility, select any item, access the context menu, and choose Suppress to hide it from the board. Showing here as removed from the graphics area, choose Unsuppress to restore it. Suppressed items appear grayed out in the tree, so it's obvious what's excluded. Filtering is hierarchical. If you select a single component instance, like C11, only C11 is suppressed. If you select a component family node, for example 120RF, all instances of that component are suppressed together. This makes it easy to hide entire classes of parts in one step. Filtering is supported for components, component instances, keep-ins, keep-outs, and outlines. Use it to focus on mechanical fit, clearances, or enclosure work, while preserving the full ECAD definition for downstream exchange, so when you're ready to sync back, your suppressed items still exist in the ECAD dataset. CAM Studio continues to receive user interface refinements that make it more consistent and intuitive across Onshape. First, when switching from a workspace to a versioned tab, the CAM Studio toolbar is now hidden, just like in Part Studio's assemblies and drawings. This creates a cleaner view, clearly distinguishing between editable workspaces and fixed versions. Additionally, CAM Studio now shows the specific operation name in confirmation dialogues when deleting items such as machines, setups, tools, or toolpaths. This simple but important update helps clarify exactly what's being deleted, improving overall usability.